Olympic Fairgrounds is a perfect stage for what is annually one of the two classics in American horse racing. Many of the groom's sleeping quarters are located outside. Sports Illustrated magazine sends an artist to capture the scene. The American Broadcasting Company is here too to capture the same scene for its national television audience. St. Louis, 90 miles north, is the nearest large city to DuCoin, but the Hamiltonian will again attract a crowd estimated at 40,000. One of the 40,000 is band leader Skip Henderson. Ayers, caretaker Charlie Coleman, and veteran driver Johnny Simpson are taking nothing for granted in this power-packed Hamiltonian field. They're among the first to head trackward for their pre-race loosening up exercise. Hamiltonian sponsor is personable, capable Don Hayes. Aided and abetted by nephew Bill, son of the late beloved Gene Hayes. Talking with Associated Press sports writer Chuck Chamberlain is the Hamiltonian press corps, Frank Samuel, Chuck Flynn, and Biff Lowry. Well, the great show gets on the road with the sensational two-year-old pacer, Brett Hanover, driven by Frank Irvin, carving the McMahon Memorial Stake into straight heat wins, and victories number 15 and 16 without a defeat. A race with a real local flavor today is a $3,000 overnight trot involving young driver Don W. Hayes and his quick bay mare, Wendy Skeeter. Hard-working young Mr. Hayes get up to win the sentimental journey over Edgewood Valley and dusty Hanover. Don is the 22-year-old son of the Hamiltonian sponsor. And his proud parents join him in Victory Lane. Beautiful Victory Lane is also the scene of a sorrowful occasion on this 39th Hamiltonian day. Gene Hayes served the sport he loved long and well, but not nearly long enough, the eulogy read. And the plaque presented to the Hayes family by Harness Racing Institute stressed the inspiration of his leadership, the strength and stature he lent to the growth and prestige of American harness racing. The Hamiltonian stake today will carry a purse of $115,281. And the nine great three-year-old trotters competing for a share of that prize have already accumulated a combined total of $300,500 in earnings thus far during the 1964 season. Once again, the Hamiltonian is one of the richest of races for the richest of horses. Ayers was branded as an extremely headstrong horse last year, particularly after one temperamental afternoon at Delaware, Ohio, when he suddenly pulled out of the race and headed straight for the barn. There's been no such cutting up this season, however, as his record of 8 victories and 9 starts indicates. The post parade for the Hamiltonian first heat. Darkman with driver Ralph Baldwin. Edie Count with Billy Houghton. Big John with Eddie Wheeler. Scribe Rodney, Bruce Nichols up. Sasebo with Jim Hackett. Rainwater and Del Manjus. Ayers, Johnny Simpson driving. Speedy Rodney with Billy Shooter. And the Devil with Bobby Camper. In a final score is Speedy Count, the number two favorite. The notional Ayers gets ready for his race with another horse keeping him close company up front. Big John does the honors here. Starter John Dale eases the field in behind his big mobile starting gate, and we're ready for the first heat of the Hamiltonian. Here they come. They're off and trotting, moving out fast. Darkman and Speedy Count. Air tips off stride, chases to start back on stride quickly as Big John moves up along the rail to be third. Going to that first turn. Leading the way, it's Darkman by two lengths. Speedy Count is second. Big John third and neck on the inside. Speedy Rodney moving up fourth on the outside, and Ayers is fifth. The Devil sixth, Sasebo seventh, Stride Rodney is eighth, and Rainwater. Speedy Count roars out of second, is up now to challenge Darkman for the lead. Into the quarter-mile mark, Speedy Count in front by a length. Darkman second, and that's the quarter in 28 and 4/5 seconds, and here comes Speedy Rodney, charging up on the outside to challenge Speedy Count for the lead. Billy Shooter off the outside now with Speedy Rodney going for and getting the lead at the end of the backstretch. That is Speedy Rodney in front by a length and 3/4. Speedy Count is second by 2 lengths. Darkman trotting third as they go to the half-mile mark. Big John is fourth. Ayers fifth. The Devil is sixth. Sasebo trotting seventh. Scribe Rodney eighth. And Rainwater is ninth. Going into the half-mile mark, they reach the half in 57 3/5 seconds. And it's Speedy Rodney showing the way in the first heat of the Hamiltonian. Speedy Count is second. Darkman trotting third. Big John is fourth as they swing round the far turn. And Ayers is fifth. The Devil sixth, and they're coming to the 3/4 with Speedy Rodney in front by two. It's Speedy Rodney, Speedy Count second, Darkness third, Big John, and here comes Ayers at the 3/4 mile mark. Ayers is out and driving now, but Speedy Rodney flashes past the 3/4, reaching that station in 1:27 3/5. Turning into the stretch, Speedy Rodney has the lead. Here comes Speedy Count out of second, thundering up now on the outside, and Ayers is flying now at the end of the stretch. This Speedy Rodney still showing the way. Speedy Count coming on. Ayers in the extreme outside is coming after that lead. And Big John coming with him. Ayers gets the lead in the mid-stretch. Big John flying on the outside. It's Ayers and Big John in the first heat of the Hamiltonian. Ayers wins it a length. Big John second. And Speedy Count is third.
A blistering 1:56 4/5 for Ayers. Tying the world trotting record of Speedy Scott and obliterating the old Hamiltonian record of 1:57 3/5 by Forless in 1963. Ayers made a bobble, a few noticeable missteps, just after leaving the starting gate. And as Johnny Simpson tells the press, he had every reason to go off stride. But Ayers did not go off stride. And the first heat of the 1964 Hamiltonian is his in world record time. A horse must win two heats before this huge crowd will see the Hamiltonian winner crowned in victory lane. But Simpson reports that he now thinks Ayers is ready to send the crowd home early. Houghton assures that Speedy Count, for one, isn't conceding anything. And neither are the other seven entries conceding anything. They're all coming back for more, even with Ayers now moving into the rail position by virtue of his first heat victory. Each of these fine three-year-old trotters has the credentials to spring an upset, as proved in that first heat when Big John, Speedy Count, Darkness, the Devil, and Scribe Rodney all were clocked in 1:59 or better. Here they are for the second time around. Darkness and Ralph Baldwin, Speedy Count and Billy Houghton, Big John with Eddie Wheeler, Scribe Rodney and Bruce Nichols, Sasebo and Jim Hackett, Rainwater, Del Manjus up, Ayers and Johnny Simpson, Speedy Rodney with Billy Shooter, and the Devil with Bobby Camper. field is in behind the John Dale starting gate for the second heat of the Hamiltonian, and here they come. Hilloff and Trotting, Ayers moved out fast with Speedy Count to the lead, Darkness in the middle of the track, and Rainwater racing out from the extreme outside into contention at the start. As they swing around the first turn, it is Ayers leading the way. Speedy Count is second, Big John drops in third at the rail, Rainwater on the outside is fourth, Darkness tight in between horses now moves up to third as they go to the quarter. It is Speedy Count leading by half a length, Darkness going up to challenge him for the lead. Racing third is Ayers at the rail, Rainwater is fourth on the outside, and Big John is fifth. Going past the quarter-mile mark in 29 1/5 seconds, and the leader is Darkness by a length and three-quarters. Speedy Count is second, Rainwater on the outside, Ayers along the rail. Sasebo moving up now on the outside, Big John fifth, and Sasebo is sixth. As they go down the back stretch, it's Speedy Rodney seventh, but Speedy Count takes out a second and goes for the lead once again. Going into the half-mile mark, Speedy Count regains the lead. Darkness is second, Ayers third on the inside. Up on the outside, Sasebo is flying three horses wide. They reach the half in 59 3/5 seconds. Speedy Count leads the way, and Sasebo has moved up to be second on the outside. Racing third is Darkness as they come around the turn. Speedy Rodney's on the move now, too. Coming to the three-quarter-mile mark, Speedy Count with the lead, Sasebo is second. Darkness is third, here comes Ayers in fourth, and Big John following him in fifth. Speedy Rodney is sixth on the outside as they come to the three-quarter-mile mark. The leader is Speedy Count by two lengths. Darkness is second along the inside, and Ayers is on the move now. They went to the three-quarters in 1:29 1. Turning for home, the leader is Speedy Count. Ayers moves up now to make his bid, and Darkness coming between horses. It is Speedy Count on the outside, Ayers, then Darkness third, and Big John moves up fourth. Speedy Count's under Erskine, Ayers is coming for the lead, and Big John is coming with him. It is Ayers and Big John on the outside. Ayers and Big John in the second heat, and Ayers wins the Hamiltonian by half a length.
1:58 1/5, and a brand new two-heat Hamiltonian record for this great cutting son of Stars Pride. Owned and bred by Mrs. Charlotte N. Shepherd of Hanover, Pennsylvania, Ayers gives Johnny Simpson his second Hamiltonian victory. Johnny's first was behind Hickory Smoke in 1957. Ayers also makes Mrs. Shepherd, wife of Lawrence C. Shepherd, the first lady owner ever to send a homebred winner to the Hamiltonian. Illinois Governor Otto Turner is on hand to present the handsome Hamiltonian trophy to Mr. Shepherd. And along with that trophy, of course, goes a check for $56,487. Ayers' three-year earnings now have reached $191,000. Simpson joins the happy group. And even Ayers wants to take a closer look at that beautiful piece of silverware. In the stands, a radiant Mrs. Shepherd receives congratulations from her daughter, Mrs. Patricia Williams, on the right, Mrs. Simpson, and a close friend, Mrs. B. Howard. Mrs. Shepherd is truly the first lady of the racing world on this historic afternoon in DuPoint. And so another Hamiltonian takes its place in history alongside other great sporting events that have produced immortal champions and monumental performances. Now the Whipple, Bianca's Futurity, and the Hamiltonian, Ayers will go on from here to sweep the triple crown of trotting in the Kentucky Futurity. The Black Beauty of young trotters in 1964, Ayers stands alone at the head of his class.